Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to learn about copyright and fair use, and we're going to kind of get warmed up on the topic. All right, here's a quiz question. Should you be able to download copyrighted music or apps for free, even if the maker doesn't want you to and has no way to make money if you don't buy their music? Yes or no? If you spent a year making a video game or a music album, would you personally want people to download it without paying for it if that was the only way for you to make money off of it? And why? So answer these questions on a piece of paper, in a Google Doc, whatever it takes. These are going to be your notes. All right. Here's the deal. So you should have already done a little preview about fair use versus infringement. Here's a question for you. I'm going to play a song for you. Let's play this thing. Okay, you guys probably recognize this, right? Oh, wait a minute. This is not Ice Ice Baby. What's happening?
Pushing down on me, pressing down on you, no man.
All right, so this is a song from Queen, and the singer is David Bowie on this one, and it's a song called Under Pressure. So they wrote this song first, and then we had this one.
VIP. Let's kick it.
All right, so at any rate, you can tell that the bass line from Ice Ice Baby is really close to the one from Under Pressure. Ice Ice Baby came next. Queen sued Vanilla Ice. Vanilla Ice said, wait, no, it's not the same. I added an extra. Yours goes dun 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 dun. Mine goes dun 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 dun. There's an extra little dun in there, and so therefore it wasn't copyright infringement. Vanilla Ice lost, Queen won, he infringed upon them, okay? So here's the deal. So why do we have copyright at all? So it's actually written into the U.S. Constitution. Our founding fathers wanted to make sure that we had copyright, and there's a reason why they really wanted it. Because the founders believe that encouraging the development of new ideas and information serves society as a whole, they felt like copyright would actually encourage people to make new things. Why is that? So the question is, how does copyright spread innovation? Why would copyright allow people to write books, make plays, make new inventions, so on and so forth? And the answer is money. Because if you can write a book and you can sell it and nobody else can, you can make money off it. So it's worth it for you to write a book or make an invention. If there is no copyright, and you wrote a book, and then somebody else could just steal it and sell it, it'd be really difficult for you to make money at it, and so that would discourage people from new stuff. So because we have copyright, it encourages people to make new things, and those people make money off of it, and then we all get to enjoy it. So our society is better, I think, because of copyright. It encourages people to innovate because there is a profit motive. That's the answer here. How does copyright spread innovation? People have a profit motive to create new things. They make money. We enjoy the new things they've created. All right, here's a quiz question. How do you obtain copyright protection? And so why don't you look up online what you have to do to obtain copyright protection? Okay? And the answer is, how do you get copyright protection? You write a book, and it's automatically protected. You write a song, and it's automatically protected. Anything that you make is automatically protected. Now, there's some further things you can do to protect yourself, but it's pretty much automatically protected when you create something new. All right, so when you make something, like write a book or whatever, oftentimes you'll see people using this copyright symbol. Okay, well, that's copyright symbol is an awful lot like putting up a no trespassing sign. Well, if you don't put up a no trespassing sign, people still aren't allowed to trespass. So you're not creating the law of no trespassing by putting up the sign. You're just asserting it. You're just saying, hey, I own this property already. There's already a law for no trespassing, but I'm putting up the sign saying that I'm going to assert that right. If you do trespass, I will call the police and you're going to get in trouble. Same thing with using the copyright symbol. It's just saying, hey, I wrote this song already, and if you steal it, I'm going to pursue damages against you. So it's kind of like a do not disturb sign or a no trespassing sign. Okay? All right. So here's why are we talking about copyright? The reason we're talking about copyright is everybody uses stuff online. Everybody's borrowing stuff online. People are doing TikTok videos online where they're using other people's songs. People are borrowing pictures and using it. So we're constantly using other people's work online, right? And so we have to understand what's right and wrong for it. Okay, so, but here's what, let's go jump back to copyright law again. So copyright means you can't, here's the things you can't do. Reproduce the work, distribute, so that means you can't, like if you can't take a book and photocopy it and sell it, or you can't even if you're not selling it, you can't photocopy it. You can't distribute copies of the work. You can't give it to people. You can't, so if somebody writes a play, you can't perform it publicly. If somebody that creates a piece of artwork, you can't take a copy of it and display it. Or you can't create derivatives of the work. So if somebody writes a book, you can't turn it into a play or a movie. Or you can't do a translation into a different language. You can't do, like, if somebody wrote a book, you can't write part two. You couldn't do Harry Potter part 13, right? You can't do a derivative of the work. So this is what you can't do. Okay, but here's what you can do. So there's a newer, copyright law came first, and then with the digital age, we decided, like, copyright's a little too restrictive. We need to be able to do some certain things with copywritten work. So the Fair Use Doctrine allows users to make use of copyrighted works without permission or payment when the benefit to society outweighs the cost to the copyright holder. Well, that's not the actual law. That's kind of the reason for the law. But here's what it does. So it allows limited use. So you can't use all of it, but part of it. There's limitations to the use of copyrighted material without permission from the copyright for the following purposes. So you might be able to use somebody's work because of the law of fair use if it's a criticism. So you're like talking about a book or criticizing a movie. You're doing a parody of a movie. You're reporting about something. For the purpose of research and scholarship. So that's for us. That's why we can pretty much use whatever we want, because we're doing it for the purposes of scholarship. So we're doing it for schoolwork. So that's for the purposes of scholarship. And so I'm allowed to use a bunch of stuff because usually when I'm using stuff, it's for the purposes of teaching. All right. So, but just because we're doing it for criticism, parody, news reporting, research or scholarship, and teaching, there's still some other things we need to follow. We're going to talk about those things next. But first, you need to answer this question. What purposes make it okay to use copyrighted work based on fair use? And it's 1, 2, 3, 4, those right there. Okay, now let's go to the next thing, fair use factor. So even if you're using them for 1, 2, 3, 4, these five reasons, here's some other things to look at as well. So the purpose of the character and character of the use, including whether use is of a commercial nature or is for not. So are you using it to make money or for nonprofit? That's gonna be part of whether you could actually get sued or not. So is it fiction or nonfiction, published or unpublished, the amount of the work used, and the effect of the use upon the potential market for the copy. So if what you're doing is making it impossible for the original author or writer to make money, so here's some idea things that you have to, that if you got taken to court, that they would look at. All right, what are the fair use factors? Write these down, these four things in your own work. All right, here's a question. Is the following fair use or infringement? If I make a song using somebody else's melody and change the words, is that fair use or infringement? So something like Weird Al Yankovic would do. Is that fair use or infringement? I make copies of a song and give them to my students so that I can teach them about racism. Is that fair use or infringement? You buy a song and make copies for your friends. This question was made back in the day when people actually bought DVD CDs from the store. You take a picture off of Mr. Travis's website and Photoshop it to look different and then sell it. You take a picture off of Mr. Travis's professional website and Photoshop it, or GIMP it in our case, because we're gonna be using GIMP depending on the year. And then you put it up on your wall, copyright or fair use or infringement. You take a picture off of the web and put it in your collage. Okay, so let's go over these things. Make sure you answer fair use or infringement on these questions. Number one is infringement for sure. Number two, this one is fair use because it's for the purpose of scholarship and teaching. Number three, you buy a song and make copies for your friend. Infringement for sure because you're making copies of it. All right, so this one, Mr. Travis' website, sell it, infringement for sure. Number five, a lot of people think this is fair use. No, this is also infringement. Even though you're not selling it, you can't do it. Take a picture off of the web and use it in your collage. This is fair use because it's for the purposes of scholarship. All right. So let's go on to the next section. What are we going to, now that we know all about copyright and fair use, or at least a little bit about it, what are we going to do? Okay, so you're going to cite all the images you get online. So you got to use, you got to get three images that you take, and then you got to get a few more images on the internet, and you got to cite the source of those things. So we're going to do a works cited page. If you found the image online, you'll need to access the date. The main thing is I want the URL. Where did you get that? And the URL should never be Google. The URL, let's take a look at what I'm talking about. Let's see here. So let's say I look up cats. Okay, so this is not the movie. So if you, oh, terrible. Okay, so let's say this. If I click on this, this is not from Google. So what we need to do is actually go to that website. And so this would be the URL of this picture. It'd be icatcare.org. Okay. Anyway, so that's what you're gonna need to write that down in a Google Doc of all the images that you get offline. Okay. The other thing that we're gonna do is you're gonna add the copyright symbol to your collage or your composite. And again, that doesn't create the copyright law. It just says that you're asserting that, hey, this is my work. Don't use it. So here's the reiterating. If you found the image online, you'll need to access the URL. So you're gonna have a Google Doc that says works cited at the top. And then you're going to paste the picture, and then you're going to put the URL where you got it. Okay, I think that's it. Let's call it